Good morning, students. Can you hear me clearly? So students, can you hear me clearly? Is the sound clear? Excuse me, students, can you hear me? Is the sound clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now please silence your device. Okay, so in our last lecture, we have seen some applications of Laplace transformation, and today we'll do the same thing. We'll see the application of Laplace transformation that in solving differential equation by using Laplace transformation. And in your last two classes, in one class, you have learned how can you solve a single differential equations. And in the second class, you have learned about the solution of the system of differential equations. And today, I also solve a solution by using Laplace transformation of a single equation. But here, there is a difference if you make a comparison with the previous one, because in our today's problem, the coefficient of x double prime or y prime is t. And in our previous problems, the coefficient for the first derivative, second derivative, or simply y is constant term. But here in our today's problem, it is variable t. So the problem is solved by using Laplace transformation. The problem is t y double prime plus t minus 1 y prime minus y is equals to 0. And here your condition is, okay, so here we can see that the values for y at the point 0 is 5 and at point infinity is 0. That means here the boundary condition is given, not, okay, here the boundary condition is given and the range for this interval is from 0 to infinity. So the problem is t y double prime plus t minus 1 y prime minus y is equals to 0. And here you can see that the coefficient for the second derivative, for the first derivative, are represented in terms of variable t. Here the coefficient is not constant term, right? Here the coefficient for y double prime or the coefficient for y prime is not a constant term. Here basically they are represented, or the coefficients are represented in terms of variable coefficients. So these equations are known as equation with variable coefficients. So I hope you get the point, how can you will differentiate this one with the first one, okay? So at first we will consider that this is our given equation number one, and as like the previous one, we will use the formula or the Laplace transformation on both sides of this equation, okay? Just a minute. Here, I think you got the point. This equation is different if you make a comparison with the previous one, because here the coefficients are variable coefficients, okay? T, T minus 1, these are the variable coefficients, not constant term. This is our given equation. Now we will take Laplace transformation on both sides of 1. Taking Laplace transformation of both sides of 1. So it will be Laplace transformation of t y double prime. From here it will be y t into y prime minus y prime. So I just write down as Laplace transformation of t y prime minus Laplace transformation of y prime minus Laplace transformation of y is equals to 0. And we'll consider, Laplace transformation of y is equals to capital Y. Okay, we will consider that Laplace transformation of y is equals to capital Y. Now you have to find the Laplace transformation of 2t y double prime. So can anyone say which procedure or which property is appropriate for finding the Laplace transformation of t into y double prime?
Multiplication and, with t.
sorry, multiplication by t, thank you. Here you have to use the properties multiplication by t to the power n, and here the values for n is equals to simply 1. Okay, so the formula was Laplace transformation of t to the power n. Probably here it is a force. There is another function. I'm considering that function is y double prime, and it is the formula minus 1 to the power n d to the power n by ds to the power n into f of s. And this f of s is the Laplace transformation of y double prime. Okay, this f of s is the Laplace transformation of y double prime. That means here this f of s is Laplace transformation of y double prime. So at first you need the formula for Laplace transformation of y double prime, which is your f of s. And after that we will put the properties multiplication by t to the power n, where n is 1. So for this one, our n is 1. So it will be t, it will be 1, it will be 1. So minus 1 d by ds, and here it is f of s. And this f of s is the Laplace transformation of y double prime. And all of you know the formula for Laplace transformation of second derivative term, that is s square y minus s y of 0 minus y prime. Okay, y prime 0. So this is your y double prime, and which is considered as f of s. Now put this result y s square y minus s y of 0 minus y prime 0, which is the Laplace transformation of second derivative of y, and consider this is as f of s. And the formula is for the property t to the power n is minus 1 to the power n d to the power n by ds to the power n, and here for the power of t is 1, so it will be 1, it will be 1 1. Okay, so now we will put this result here for the first term. Now we will put this result. Students, please write down your ID number on the chat box. So from here you can write down that minus 1 d by ds f of s. F of s is the Laplace transformation of second derivative of y. So it will be s square y minus s y of 0 minus y prime 0. Okay. Now for the second one, you have to do the same thing. You have to use the property multiplication by t to the power n. And here the power for t to the power n is 1. So it will be minus 1 to the power 1, d to the power 1, ds to the power 1 into f of s. And in a similar way, you have to find f of s is the Laplace transformation of y prime, right? Here it is basically formula of f of s. And this f of s is the Laplace transformation of y prime. And you know y prime is equals to s y minus y of 0, right? This is the formula for Laplace transformation of first order derivative. S y minus y of 0. Now put this result for f of s. Put this result for f of s. It will be s y minus y of 0. Okay. So for this one, minus Laplace transformation of y prime, and Laplace transformation of y prime is simply s y minus y of 0. And the last one is Laplace transformation of y, which is simply y is equals to 0. Okay. Now you have to complete this evaluation. Okay, so now you have, now we will put the values for y of 0 and y prime 0. Okay. If you memorize that, you can remember the y of 0 equals to 5 and y of infinity is equals to 0. These two boundary condition is given in your problem, right? Two boundary condition is given in your problem. And here, there is a problem y prime 0. It is not given, right? In your portion. It is not given y prime 0 is equals to what, but it's a condition, it's an initial condition. So I will consider y prime 0 is equals to, will be another constant term. I just consider it. This is a constant term, which is C. Okay. So now put the result for this. Here it will be minus 1 d by ds is square y minus s y of 0. And the values for y of 0 is given in your question, that is 5. Into 5. And here the values for y prime 0 is not given in your question, but it's the initial condition. So we will consider that the result for this initial condition will be a constant term. And we will consider that constant term as C. So it is C plus minus 1 d by ds is y minus y of 0, which is 5 in your given question, minus is y. Here it is 5 minus 5 minus y is equals to 0. Okay. So we get this term after putting the values for y of 0, y prime 0, and to be considered the values for y prime 0 is equals to c. So here you may write down it as y prime 0 is equals to c. We just consider this, okay? Now differentiate these terms. Here it is minus 1. Differentiate this for the first time. So for this time, y is a function of s. So it is differentiable with respect to s. Now you have to use the formula of uv for differentiation. So the first one, for first one, it is 2s into y plus, for the second one, it is s into y prime. For s square y, the differentiation will be 2s into y, and for the second one, it will be s square into y prime. Okay. Now for the second one, it will be minus 5, and for the third one, c, here c is a constant term, so it will be equals to 0. Okay. So it will be equals to 0. Now we have completed this part. Now for the second part, minus 1 d by ds is y. Here s is a function of n, and sorry, y is the function of s, so it is differentiable with respect to s. Now use the formula of u into v for differentiation. So for the first term we consider is y, and for the second one it will be s into y prime, right? You just use the UV formula for differentiation, and here minus 5, 5 is constant, so its differentiation will be 0. And from here we get minus s y plus 5 minus y is equals to 0, okay? Now multiply this term by minus 1 and this term by minus 1. It will be minus 2 s y minus s square y prime plus 5. From here, it will be minus y minus s y prime minus s y plus 5 minus y is equals to 0. Okay. Now you have to just complete this evaluation or simplification. That means you have to just complete the addition and subtraction. And after completing addition and subtraction, here your answer will be something like this: s square plus s y prime plus 3s plus 2y is equals to 10. Okay. So if you complete your addition subtraction in this line, that means after simplification this line, we get this one: s square plus s y prime plus probably it is 3s plus 2y is equals to 10. Okay. Now you have to find the solution. You have to find the solution. Here you can see that it's a first order differential equation, and you have to solve this first order differential equation to find ys. Okay. From here you have to find simply ys, and after taking the inverse Laplace transformation of ys, you will get y of t. That is the solution of your given problem. So it's a first order differential equations of y of s. So you have to now solve this. So at first I will divide both sides by the term s square plus s. Okay, so after completing the division, it will be y prime plus 3s plus 2 divided by s square plus s into y is equals to 10 divided by s square plus s. Okay, after division by the term s square plus s on the both sides, we get this one. And here now use partial fraction for this part. Use partial fraction for this part, and using partial fraction, the result is qs plus 1 divided by s square plus s plus 1 by s. After using partial fraction from this term, we can write this into y is equals to 10 divided by s into s plus 1. So we have seen that it's a first order differential equations, and now you have to solve it. And for solving it, at first you have to find the what? Integrating factor. For solving this first order differential equations, you have to find the integrating factor. Students, have you completed the course OD and PD from mathematics division? I think you have learned the solution of first order differential equations in that course OD and PD, how to solve a, right?
Yes, ma'am, but 6 মাস আগের কথা ভুলে
গেছেন. Okay, I just remember it here. Basically, the rules is that suppose I have a first order differential equation, something like this, x prime plus n square x is equals to c. Okay, so at first from here you have to find the integrating factor. I just give the idea how can you solve this. Okay, this is not the part of your solution of this problem. So find the integrating factor, and for finding integrating factor you have to take it as e to the power integration with respect to, here the variable is x, so you have to integrate with respect to x. And which one will have to be integrated? The coefficient of the x, okay, not x prime. Here you have to integrate with respect to x, the coefficient of x, not x prime. So here the coefficient for x is n squared. And the integrating factor will be e to the power n squared t. And it is not fixed that here it will be n squared. It can be any type of constant term. Okay, here the values for n squared will be any type of constant term.
ম্যাম ওটা dt হবে না dx ইন্টিগ্রেশন n স্কয়ার dt
yes yes sorry so here after completing integration basically here your variable x is here x is a function of t that's why you have to integrate with respect to dt okay here x is considered as a function of t, so you have to integrate with respect to t. Since here y is a function of s, so you have to integrate with respect to s. Okay, so this is our integrating factor e to the power n squared t. Now the procedure is you have to multiply both this left side and right side by this term. Okay, you have to multiply both left side and right side by this your integrating factor, and after that you have to take the integration, and after taking integration you will get the solution of this first order differential equation. So what is the procedure? At first find the integrating factor. After, the second step is multiply both sides by that integrating factor, and integrating both sides you will get the solution of your problem. Okay, so now for this problem you have to, or we have to find the integrating factor of this equation. Okay, so what will be the integrating factor? Integrating factor is e to the power integration coefficient for y, that is 2s plus 1 divided by s square plus s plus 1 by s. You have to integrate this with respect to ds. Okay, since your y is the function of s, so you have to integrate with respect to ds. And from here you have, after completing integration for this term, it will be log is a square plus s, right? Because if you consider this is f of x, it will be f prime x. And you know the integration of f prime x by f of x is equals to log f of x. So it will be log f of x. And for this one, it will be log s, right? For this one, it will be log s. Now, consider the equation as equation number 2. This can be written as e to the power log s into, here from here you can write down that s is, this is a addition, and for addition we can write down it as s into s square plus s. Okay, you can write down this as, so here e to the power log x, and according to that formula you know that there is a formula e to the power log x is equals to x. So using that formula, we can write down that it will be only s into s square plus s. Okay. using this formula, we can write down this. So the integrating factor will be what? S into S square plus n, and from here you can write down S square into S plus 1. So that is the integrating factor of our equation number 2. Now we will multiply our equation number 2 by this integrating factor on both sides. Okay, this is our equation. We'll multiply both sides by this term. Okay, multiplying equation 2 by the integrating factor. Okay, and our integrating factor is this, so we just multiply this equation by this term. This is our equation number 2. Now we will multiply both sides of this equation by the term. So for this, it will be s square into s plus 1 y prime for this 2s plus 1 divided by s square plus s plus 1 by s into s square into s plus 1 y 10 into s square s plus 1 divided by s into s plus 1. So if you multiply both sides, then you will get this. And from here, you can see that it will cancel this term. This from here, it will be simply s. And on the left side, if you write down y into s square, s plus 1. The differentiation, d by ds, okay, is equals to 10s. Is it possible to write down this? Please check it. Here I write down y into s square s plus 1, and the differentiation of this. If you differentiate these by using UV formula with respect to s, then you will get this term and this term. And if you simplify this, you will get the term basically, probably it will be 3s square plus 2s, something like this. Okay. And these will cancel each other. So please check it. If you differentiate this term by using UV formula, you will get this one and this one. Okay. So I just write down it as y, differentiation of y s square s plus 1, because this and these are the same thing. If you differentiate it with respect to this, we will get this line. That's why for this line, we can write this. Now we will integrate both sides of this equation. Okay. Integrating both sides. And one interesting thing is that here, if you multiply both sides by the integrating factor, then you can directly write down that your variable y into s squared is plus 1. That means your function into integrating factor with respect to your variable s. And here it's not necessary to take that differentiation of this is equals to this. It is automatically, okay? It's happened automatically. If you multiply both sides by the integrating factor, then on the left side, you will get your function y into integrating factor, and the differentiation of this term is equal to the previous term. On the right side, you have to just evaluate this, okay? So for the left term here, it is not necessary that to take differentiation of this term is equals to this. You can directly write down this. So here, if you complete the integration, then on the left side, it will be y s squared into s plus 1. And on the right side, it will be 10 into s squared by 2, right? 10 into s squared by 2 plus a. So from here, you will get y s squared into s plus 1, 5 s squared plus a. Okay? So I think probably from here, we will get the result y of s. We will get the result y of s, but for obtaining y of s, you will have to multiply both sides by s square into s plus 1. So multiply both sides by this. It will be y. From the right side, it will be 5 s square divided by s square into s plus 1. And for c, it will be s square into s plus 1. Okay. So now y of s is equals to this, and you have to use inverse Laplace transformation for obtaining y of t, which is the solution of your given problem. this is your y of s, but this is not your solution. Now you have to use inverse Laplace transformation to obtain your solution y of t. Okay, so take inverse Laplace transformation. Taking inverse Laplace transformation, it will be inverse Laplace transformation of capital Y, 5 into here this and this will cancel each other. Inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s plus 1 plus c. Here c is a constant term, right? So c inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s square into s plus 1. Here for the first one, inverse Laplace transformation 1 by s plus 1, you can directly use the formula e to the power at. But for the second one, it is c into inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s square into s plus 1. But for this term, we will use the convolution theorem because it's a product of two functions of s, right? So we will take the convolution theorem for finding Laplace transformation of this, okay? And consider this equation as equation number 3 or 4. As equation number 4. So, at first we will find the Laplace transformation of this. So, Laplace transformation of 1 by s squared into s plus 1, it can be written as Laplace inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s squared into 1 by s plus 1. So here we have found that it's a multiplication of 2, 1. One is 1 by s square plus 1 and another is 1 by s plus 1. So at first we will find the inverse Laplace transformation of these and this. So then the inverse Laplace transformation 1 by s square. Here we will try to find the convolution theorem, okay? So for applying convolution theorem, at first you have to find the inverse Laplace transformation of these two functions, which is in the multiplication. So the Laplace transform, inverse Laplace transformation 1 by s square, what is the formula for this? It is simply t, and there is a direct formula for this. Inverse Laplace transformation 1 by s to the power n plus 1 is equal to t to the power n. And here s to the power 1, s to the power n plus 1, that means 1 plus 1. So the values for n is 1 and it will be t to the power n, that means t to the power 1, which is t, okay? So this is the inverse Laplace transformation of this term. Now, for this one and inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s plus 1. Here you can just use the formula for e to the power at and it will be e to the power minus t. Since the formula is inverse Laplace transformation 1 by s minus a is equals to e to the power at, and here a is minus 1, so you can write down e to the power minus t. Okay, so we have found the inverse Laplace transformation of two functions which are in the form of multiplication. So consider this is as f of t and this is as z of t, right? Or this is as z of t, this is as f of t. You know the formula for convolution theorem, okay? Now you will use the convolution theorem. Using convolution theorem. We may write down the inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s squared into 1 by s plus 1. And this is equal to integration 0 to t z of u, f of u, z of t minus u, d, right? This is the convolution theorem. And here it can be also written as z of u, f of t minus u du. Both these two one are correct, okay? Here we will use this one, c of u, f of t minus u du. This is the convolution theorem. So now put this result 0 to t. This is your z of t. So your z of u will be e to the power minus u. This is your f of t. So your f of t minus u will be t minus u into du. Now you have to simply complete this integration, okay? So we have found the inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s square into s plus 1 is equals to integration 0 to t e to the power minus u t minus u du. So you have to use the UV formula for completing this integration. And after completing this integration, your result will be t plus e to the power minus t minus e to the power zero. That means t plus e to the power t, e to the power minus t minus one, okay? So this is the result for the inverse Laplace transformation of the term 1 by s square into s plus 1. And for finding this, you have to use the convolution theorem. And you know that for convolution theorem, you have to complete this integration. And it's a very simple integration by using UV formula, okay? And the result is given here of this integration, that is t plus e to the power minus t minus 1. Now we will go for the equation number 4, and from there we find the solution of this given problem. What is this? Now we will go for the equation number 4. From equation 4. So what is this? It is inverse Laplace transformation of y is equals to 5 into inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s plus 1. Plus c into inverse Laplace transformation of 1 by s squared into s plus 1. Okay. And for this term, the inverse Laplace transformation will be, here it is y of t. It is y of t. Here it is 5 into e to the power minus t. And c into, we have found the inverse Laplace transformation of this, which is t plus e to the power minus t minus 1. Okay. T plus e to the power minus t minus 1, and consider this equation as equation number 6. Consider this equation as equation number 5. Okay. We are at the end of the solution, but here there is a simple problem. Here there is a term c. Okay. Here there is a term c, and here c is arbitrary constant, and you have to find out this arbitrary constant. But how can you get this arbitrary constant? For finding this arbitrary constant, you have to given your boundary condition. That means it is given, what is given? Y of infinity is equals to what? Zero. So y of infinity is equals to zero. That means if you say t is equals to infinity, then the result y of t will be zero, okay? So I just use this given condition here. So from 5, it will be y of infinity. We will replace t by infinity. So it will be y of infinity is equals to 5. T is infinity to the power minus infinity. C, t is infinity e to the power minus infinity minus 1, which is equal to 0. This is equal to this, and this is equal to 0. So you may write down this is equal to 0. Okay. From here, we may write down that 5 into e to the power minus infinity is equals to 0. It will be c into infinity, and e to the power minus infinity is equals to 0. So it will be 0 into minus c is equals to 0, right? Okay. So from here, we can find out c into infinity to the power minus infinity minus 1, c into infinity minus c is equals to 0. So your c is equals to c into infinity. And if you, c infinity to the power minus infinity minus 1. So from here, if we take a common of c, it will be infinity minus 1 is equals to 0. And the fact is, if you subtract 1 from infinity, then it will be obviously infinity, right? If you subtract 1 from infinity, then it will be obviously infinity. So c is equals to 0 divided by infinity minus 1. Okay? C is equals to 0 divided by infinity minus 1. So can anyone say what will be the result for this? Yes, it will be 0, because if you simply consider that 0 into 1 by infinity minus 1, And here one infinity minus one is simply infinity, and one log infinity is equals to zero. So this term will be zero. So the values for c is equals to zero. Now we'll put the values for c is equals to zero in our equation number five.
ম্যাম আমি তো ইনফিনিটি পাইছি সি এর ভ্যালু কিভাবে পাইছি ম্যাম ওই যে সি ইনটু ইনফিনিটি যদি ফার্স্টে ম্যাম মুছন না ম্যাম এই যে এখানে
এখানে
হ্যাঁ এইটা সি ইনটু ইনফিনিটি যদি আমি ফার্স্টে ইনফিনিটি লিখি কারণ সি ইনটু ইনফিনিটি তো ইনফিনিটি ইনফিনিটি মাইনাস সি ইকুয়ালস টু 0 সো সি ইকুয়ালস টু ইনফিনিটি হয়ে গেছে ম্যাম তো এটা কিভাবে হলো
হিয়ার ওয়ান থিং ইজ দ্যাট সিন্স উই আর ট্রাইং টু ফাইন্ড দা ভ্যালুস অফ সি সো ইন দ্যাট সেন্স হিয়ার সি ইজ দা ভেরিয়েবল অফ ইওর ফাংশন রাইট
ইয়েস ম্যাম
You cannot vanish your c. We know that c is constant, but when we are working for finding the values of c, then in that sense, your variable will be c. So you cannot vanish your variable. When you are trying to find the solution of an equation, in that case, you cannot vanish your variable. Okay. So from here, you will get the result for c, which is equals to zero. Now put the value c is equals to zero in your equation number five. Put c is equals to zero in equation number five. So from here we get y of t is equals to 5 into e to the power minus t, and it is 0 into t plus e to the power minus t minus 1. And when it is 0 into this, then it will be vanished. It will be simply 0. So finally we can write down y of t is equals to 5 into e to the power minus t, which is our required solution. Okay, this is your required solution, which is the required solution. So in this way, we can find the, basically the main procedure is same. You have to take Laplace transformation, you have to take inverse Laplace transformation, but there is a difference between this one and the previous one of first single differential equations, because here the variable of your differential equation is represented in terms of t. That means here it is variable coefficient, and in our previous problems it is simply constant. That's why the calculation for the previous maths is easier than this. Okay, since here you are carrying the coefficient in terms of variable, that's why you have to face difficulties for solving this math, but the procedure is same. So students, basically we have completed our whole syllabus for Fourier analysis and Laplace transformations. Since we have three classes, right? We have three classes.
Yes, ma'am.
So in the last lecture, in the last week, we will give the review one day for Fourier analysis and the second day for Laplace transformation. So in that sense, we have one more class, which will happen probably tomorrow. No, your next class is Tuesday, and in that class, I will try to solve some problems which we not solve in the Fourier analysis because of our short time, or I think that I cannot finish the syllabus. That's why I skip that part. So in the next class, I will discuss one part from Fourier analysis, okay? And the last class of the last week, we will take the review classes. In your next class, which will end on the Tuesday, we will discuss a new part from Fourier analysis. So that's all, students, for today. Take care, everyone.
Assalamu alaikum.
You may leave now, students. You may leave now, and before leaving this class, please write down your ID number for only one time. Those who written your ID number, then leave now.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, did you receive my work?
Sorry, repeat your question.
I was asking if you received my work. You asked me to submit it in
it. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
ম্যাম রিভিউ যে ক্লাসটা নেবেন ওখানে ম্যাম আমাদের ফাইনালে তো মানে কোশ্চেন প্যাটার্নটা ছোট হয়ে গেছে, তো আপনি যদি রিভিউ ক্লাসে ওই ফাইনালে যে যে টপিকগুলো ইম্পর্টেন্ট ওগুলো যদি একটু করাইতেন তাহলে ভালো হতো ম্যাম।
আসলে একটা রিভিউ ক্লাসে আমি চাইলেও করাতে পারবো না সবকিছু, আমি যেটা করতে পারবো আপনাদেরকে বলে দিতে পারবো।
ইয়েস ম্যাম, ওটাই মানে টপিকগুলো, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ
টপিকগুলো ডিসকাস করতে পারবো এবং কোন ম্যাথগুলো বা কোন টপিকগুলো আপনারা পিক করবেন সেটা বলে দিতে পারবো।
ইয়েস ম্যাম, এটাই।
কারণ একটা ক্লাসে তো আসলে এত কিছু করানো যাবে না ঠিক আছে ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ
আসসালামু আলাইকুম
ওকে ওয়ালাইকুম আসসালাম